Alright, let's enter the IDTechEx USA 2016 Exhibition Hall. Checking in. Let's enter right here. So I'll need to do some videos. Dino Light. Hey, can I do an interview with you?
Sure.
All right. This is my video here.
Okay.
My website. Okay, I'm gonna go right here.
This model is 1.3 megapixel. We also have a 5 megapixel model.
5
megapixel.
Yeah.
So we're here with we're here with Dino Light. And hello, so who are you?
I'm Sean.
So Dino Light, you making a small microscope?
Yeah, we're selling them here in North and South America. We're made in Taiwan.
So what are we looking at here? Is this the consumer product?
This is a professional product. They all come with a 2-year warranty, free tech support, free software. This is our Edge series. They have variable magnification.
This is real time?
That's
real?
That's real time, yeah. I can move this watch. You'll see it move up there.
Is this watch?
I don't think so. It's a cheap watch that we don't want.
Cheap one, but it looks pretty cool.
So, yeah, these are designed to be very durable, light, compact. They're designed to be, usable in the field if you need to, or, in the lab or the office. If you're going to use them handheld, you just touch the object that you're looking at and adjust the magnification to match. So it'll be in focus at two different spots. It's about 50x, and again, closer to about 180x there.
Whoa, how can it be two different spots?
The lenses move inside of the shaft here when you change the magnification, so it changes the distance.
Kind of like a zoom?
Kind of like a zoom.
Yeah. All right. And but Dino Light, I've seen those, like, you have all the way down to a very affordable consumer, don't you?
Sorry, we do offer a $99 model. It's got limited features, but it's still usable and produces a very nice image. That's mostly for classrooms and educational purposes.
Are there many classrooms, many kids using it?
There are. Yeah, we donate several in other classrooms. They come together and they buy it just for learning.
And you've been doing this for a while, no?
Yeah, they've been selling these for about 10 years now.
10 years?
Yeah.
And right here we have just how it looks like.
Well, yeah, this is our mobile Wi-Fi spot. So what you do, instead of plugging the Dino Light into the computer, you plug it right in here to this, and it generates a Wi-Fi hotspot that up to 10 devices can connect to. So we're showing off, this is how you would have an iPad using the microscope.
Nice. Normally, how does it do that? It needs to have the driver and everything, and it's running a little Linux in there, or?
I'm not sure. You just buy this device, you plug it in, or use the battery, and that's it. That's all you have to worry about, and that's all I worry about.
Nice, so no need for a big computer.
That's right.
And what are you talking about here at the Print Electronics Show? Who's going to be buying this for? What are you going to be using it for?
A lot of manufacturers for inspection, quality control, doing measurements, documentation, and cataloging. Yeah. We go to about 70 different trade shows a year. we cover all sorts of industries. We show that in our brochure here. You know, industrial, forensics, PCB. It's probably what we imagine this show would be close with.
Can we check it over there a little bit? That's a demo of that.
Yeah, we have another station over there.
So let's go to the closer there.
Yes.
Sorry. If I'm going over here, yeah. Are you checking your...
And we can, so you can see the two different. This is our standard working distance and our long working distance.
Yeah.
If you need room to get a tool in there, or if you just can't get close enough to
the
object.
Move the PCB in and under.
You want to see the PCB? Sure.
So what's the price of that one? You said it was a professional one.
Yeah, this one is $629. And this one has an extra feature with extended depth of field. I believe it's $899.
All right. Do you have many customers in the U.S.?
Oh yeah, lots and lots of customers.
But you also sell worldwide or mostly in the U.S.?
It is sold worldwide. We're the distributor for North and South America, but we have distributors all across the world. So if you need to get it in Europe, you can do it. We're also selling it here at our booth, and we offer a 10% trade show discount.
Cool. All right. Let me give you my card.
Great. I think I have it.
Right.
Maybe I get another one.
I think I did a video with Dynalite like 8 years ago or something at a trade show.
It's probably been a while. I haven't been here that long.
It was a long time ago. In Germany, probably, at the IFA. Can I have your card?
Oh, great. Sure. Yeah, this is our general card.
Cool.
If you don't mind. Maybe you can send me a link to the video once it's out.
Yeah. It's going to be in 360 also.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Very cool.
All right.
Okay.
The first video. Okay.
Okay.
Thanks. Right here. Do you work for this?
Yeah, we do, yeah.
This one? Oh, the whole...
Just this one, yeah.
There. Is it, is it possible that I could do a video with you? Talking about what you do?
Not just yet.
Maybe a little bit later, yeah? During the show. No. It'd be nice maybe...
So what do you guys do?
I'm like a video interview guy.
Right.
So it'd be nice if we could be outside the glass and we can show how flexible it is or something. Maybe we can try later during the show.
I'll have to think about it.
Okay, I'll come back later.
Okay,
thank you. Hey, how are you?
Hi.
It got lots of views.
Yes, it did.
Yeah. Uh-huh. So is it like mass production now?
No.
Not yet?
No.
Can't you make it happen in 6 months?
Maybe you can help me make it happen in 6 months.
Where's the Samsung guys and everybody?
I haven't talked to them yet, but we've been contacted by just about every major player in the world. So,
is it because of the video?
I'm sure it's part.
Oh,
I'm
that's
sure.
Good. All right.
Yeah, so thank you very much.
Cool. So when your company becomes bigger than the rest of the consumer electronics business, then you remember to invite me to the trade show.
Definitely. You'll be honored guest at the inauguration, factory inauguration.
Did you see all the comments? Did you reply to some
of
them?
No, I haven't. I haven't
been following that. People asking, is it real or is it happening?
I haven't been doing that.
You just go on YouTube and answer them. And you can use
I can answer in your?
Yeah. Okay. You can have a YouTube account that's called Broadbit if you want. Then so then they know it's you answering. You know.
Okay.
And you can just just on YouTube.
Yeah,
check
I haven't
it out.
Doing that at all. It's a
I
good
think
idea.
It's like 30 or 40 comments or something. Check it out.
Okay.
Right? Cool.
Excellent. So what else have you found?
Oh, we can do a new video later. You know, maybe.
What?
Maybe there's some updates or something more you can say.
Sure. Think about what the main thing is. You know, we've gotten investment and we've built the team, and we're planning to make the first cylindrical cells in the next month or two. Let's hope.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Where?
In Finland.
Oh, that's not far, so I can just jump over.
Yes.
Yeah.
Definitely.
You have lights, right? Because it's going to be dark. Yeah. Yes.
Have lights.
Yeah. Yeah. Just joking. That's okay.
Yeah.
That's my funny.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's even heated sidewalks.
That's great. Sidewalks?
Yeah, in the downtown, they heat the sidewalks.
Whoa, so the, all the snow just...
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, that's interesting. Okay, cool. Okay, we'll talk later. We can do an updated video talking about the latest status, maybe.
Okay, all right. Okay. I'm going to be giving a talk tomorrow.
All right.
So I have the... tomorrow afternoon.
Cool.
One of the last ones.
All right. Okay, all right. See you later.
Yeah.
See you. Hello. Hey. How are you? Yeah. It's live. So, do you think we can do the video?
Sure.
All right. Is there any chance this cannot be on the table, right?
Is it stick a little bit? Now that I've got it taped down, but I can bring it up.
Can you maybe tape it back on later and then put it up here?
Sure. Absolutely. Thank you so much. So, yeah. We'll see you.
This is hard to film in under the glass. And then,
all the reflections, I know.
Yeah.
Hi, how are you?
Good.
Interesting. So, where are the, how come you're listed in?
Yes.
I got my outfit.
Nice.
So
and these, can we also have those up?
That
is cool.
So, essentially, it's just a wireless.
And it'd be great is while I do the video, maybe you could grab some of this up and show it like this, you know?
Sure. Wireless.
Right, let's do it.
So,
you're going to prompt me. Yeah.
Yeah.
Me to
also, the big one. One of the big ones? Yeah.
All right, these are color. That's why they're
that's great.
They're darker.
Okay. So, we're here at the IDTechEx show here. Oh, sorry. Let me just switch it over to 4K. 4K is better. Oh, sorry.
I can freeze the screen if it's too much.
That lasts about 3 hours.
Ooh, it's manual, so it's already... it's great when it turns around and everything. Yeah. Hello. Hello. I'm just testing. Testing. Okay. The mic. All right. Hello. Hello. So we're here at the IDTechEx show here with Futaba. Hello. So who are you?
Hi. My name is Terry Bassett. I'm the marketing manager for Futaba in North America. And what we're showing are plastic displays, plastic passive matrix displays.
So this is flexible. There's no glass. Is flexible, what is it, OLED?
It is OLED display technology, and it is plastic. And you can bend it. So it has a capability of being able to be bent. And actually, it's very thin. It's only about 0.25 millimeters thick.
0.25 millimeters, mm-hmm. Flexible, and you have all different kinds of shapes. What are we looking at here?
Right here, we're showing a color display. And this is a monochrome display.
So this color.
So we're able to do monochrome and full color.
This is a very thin display, right?
It is.
Small,
very
but you have
thin.
Different size.
Various sizes are commercially available as standard,
yeah.
And we can also do custom display technology. So
how can you do the different sizes? Are there there's no limits in kind of sizes? Or
typically, we like to stay under 3-inch diameter. And our resolutions go anywhere from about 100 ppi up to about 250 ppi.
Is this something that's mass-produced?
It is. We've been in mass production with these parts since 2013.
And where can people find them? And there's some mass-produced product, right?
There's
let's grab one of them.
Actually, the Huawei Top Fan was the first one to use our display.
Nice.
Recently, iFit has come out with a wearable as well using our display.
Is it powered? Can we try to show? Mm-hmm. Oh.
Four colors.
So there's a flexible for... the step tracker kind of markets.
That's right.
Then she goes with heart rate monitor and stuff like that.
It does. It has a heart rate monitor as well on this device.
All right. So what else can you do? Can you do even bigger, or you'd rather not right now? Why can you not make it like a smartphone size?
Well, passive matrix technology generally tends to be a smaller technology based, and we like to keep it within about a 3-inch diagonal. This one in particular is about 1.8 inches, so about twice this size.
Twice the size is okay. So,
it's okay.
So it could be a small smartphone, maybe.
It could be, but typically we're working with smartwatches, wearable bands, anything that has a curved surface that you need some kind of visual indicator for information.
I'm thinking like a smartphone, you could have a flexible case.
You could do a flexible case.
I have this case where I'd like the case to be an OLED over here.
You could have that thin. You could have a sub-display if you want on these cases.
What's the battery consumption compared to like a different normal OLED, or is it the same?
So typically this small one would run about 30 milliwatts for power consumption. These large color ones are much larger.
Right, but this, is it similar to a normal OLED display? AMOLED?
AMOLED, it's different as far as power consumption.
It's different, there's more power?
Well, size per size, it should be about the same, but typically AMOLEDs are much bigger. You know, you're talking about a 5-6 inch diagonal display. Yeah. Since our displays are much smaller, our power consumption is smaller.
All right, so this is, the company Futaba is from Japan?
Futaba is a Japanese company, yes.
And been doing this kind of stuff for 3 years?
Well, actually, Futaba purchased TDK Technologies back in 2012, and TDK had developed OLED technology. And once they purchased them, then we actually came out in mass production with the film technology.
All right, and these are kind of like prototype demos with the
boards? So this would be our demos that we would show to customers, and then they develop it into these really great products.
And the price is good for display?
Prices are very comfortable.
So everybody should have one.
Everybody should have one. And if you have any questions, please go to our website, which is www.futaba.com.
How about having them embedded on clothing?
You can put them in clothing as long as you protect them, as OLED technology doesn't like to be wet at all.
Maybe like a module, you can easily snap it off, put it back on.
Good, exactly. That's what the Huawei Top Band is. It's a module that pops out. So this could be washed, it could be whatever. You can charge this, and then when you're ready, you put it in.
Nice. Cool. Okay, I got it.
Okay.
All right. It's cool, huh?
I do.
Okay. All right, thanks a lot. Let me give you my card.
Oh, I have it from yesterday.
You have it, yeah?
Yes, thank you.
And did I get it from you?
I think.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Nicholas, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I hope it gets a million views. We'll see.
Me too.
And if you want...
How do I find it?
If you want, like, to help me to get a perfect text on it, maybe for you it's 5 minutes. If you send me an email with an awesome text that you like, title, description, I use your text to publish.
Okay.
Like, it could have more technical details that I didn't really ask about, like how did the screen works or something.
Sure.
Otherwise, maybe I'll try to search on the internet, but just in case,
just
maybe for you it's just 5 minutes.
And I can write you something, no problem.
Yeah. Something, just 5 minutes, something good to use. Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, bye. Let's go around here. So, the IDTechEx show this year is pretty big. It's growing every year. It goes all the way around here. All the way down here. It's huge.
I got this harness at Brandenburg.
Hi.
Hey, hello.
Can I do a video with
sure.
you? Can you talk about it?
Sure. What do you
All right.
want?
Let me give you my card. The video is going to go right here.
Okay.
Okay.
We'll keep you in the loop on our production.
Cool. I'll ask you. So we're here at the ID TechEx show. And this is a car right here. So hello, so who are you?
Hi, I'm John McMillan, CEO of Shockwave Motors. And this is our Defiant EV3 electric roadster.
So Defiant EV3, what is the idea with this car?
This car is designed for commuters.
Yeah.
Trying not to be all things to all people, just focus on the commuter market, having a fun time when you drive to work. And you've got up to a 200 mile per day range with this roadster.
200 mile per day?
Per day.
Not per charge, right?
Per charge, per day.
Per day.
It's got a single charge range of 80 to 100 miles.
All right.
What really sets us apart is you can plug into any standard outlet, 110 volt, 120 volt outlet, at home or at work, get a full recharge in about 8 hours,
yeah,
and then drive another 80 to 100 miles.
So why is it shaped like this?
Well, it's shaped like this for a few reasons. One, we wanted to give it some style. And not everybody likes the style, but at least it has style. We think a lot of electric cars look like shoeboxes on wheels. So we want to give it a little style. And we have an aerodynamic shape to it. So that means less air drag at high speeds. And three wheels means less rolling resistance at low speeds. So it's all about efficiency, and it's all about convenience.
And the driver will be strapped in nicely in there,
yeah,
safely.
Nice,
does it go fast?
About 75 miles an hour.
Is that fast acceleration also?
Yeah, it accelerates very well. Rapid
yeah.
acceleration.
So how soon is, is this real or?
This is real. We are anticipating being in production in about 9 to 12 months. In fact, we are taking deposits at this time.
But is it like this one is actually drives?
Oh, this yeah, one? This drives. Oh, yeah.
This is a prototype or
is
real?
This is a prototype. It's real.
And it charges right there?
There's the charge. You just plug it into any outlet.
Where are you based?
Right now we're based in East Tennessee, but we're anticipating setting up a facility either in Florida or California.
So how much it will cost, mass production?
Mass production, it'll be less than $25,000, and that's before any of the state and federal rebates kick in. That'll drop it down to around $20,000.
All right, this is awesome, this is great. So how do you come to make this product? Like, what's the background of the company?
Well, I've literally had a lifelong connection with electric vehicles. I'll tell you a little quick story. I remember my dad and I'm about 3 or 4 years old, sitting in the kitchen floor, working on a car starter motor. He wanted to put the starter motor on my little red pedal tractor. So he was way ahead of his time on that, because that was about 1957. And literally, since grade school, high school, and college, I've been building electric cars. We wanted to build one that people could have a lot of fun driving, get to work safely.
And you assembled a team to make this happen?
That's right.
Right. So what kind of a team do you have?